Document date is the date of the related documents. For instance, the date that the postal sales invoice have their document date. And it's based on this document date that the due date on the postal sales invoice is calculated. In posting date, we define the financial posting of the document. So we can change this to the month before if we want the posting financially to be in this month. Order date is the date for when this sales order was created. Requested delivery date is the date that the customer has requested for the delivery to be delivered. And in promised delivery date, we can state when we have promised the customer that we will deliver the order. The date about shipping is found in the shipping section. Dates defined on the document is automatically transferred to the document lines, but these can be changed if you want to. To edit dates on the lines, we mark the field and choose another date from the calendar. Now that I have changed the shipment on the line, doesn't change about the shipment on the header. If I'm on the other way around, changing the shipment date on the header, I will be asked if I want to update the lines. If I do this, all of the lines would now have been updated with the shipment date. On my sales order here, I have added requested and promised delivery date on my sales line. This I have done with personalization, which we found up in the menu here. But please be aware that these date fields are dependent on the license that you have, so you might not be able to get these fields visible.